I mean, I think the private sector clients that we've been dealing with, we had decided, of course, in lending to them previously, that they were good going concerns. But what COVID had done was essentially stop business as usual. There was no such thing as business as usual anymore. What we had to focus on, in particular at EBRD at the time, was to ensure that what we thought was a liquidity crisis didn't turn into an insolvency crisis simply because of lack of flow of funds. So there's a huge focus, therefore, on trying to make sure the companies, the clients, actually survived the crisis stage and emerged and jobs was protected. Looking back on it, that has worked very well. I mean, in terms of the primary objective of ensuring company survival and ensuring jobs were also protected. There are a couple of major concerns, though, for those of us like IFC EBRD who deal with private sector particularly. One is that the whole purpose of our approach to development is to expand the list of clients that we want to work with. But in a situation where you have lockdown across all the EBRD offices, IFC offices and so on, I think there has been clearly a much greater stress on working with existing clients. So if you like, the envelope of clients has not really changed very much. And that's something that, you know, as we grapple with this new way of working, we've got to think about, because it's not good for development just to focus on existing clients. You do need to widen the envelope to include new people. The second area, I think, it's been much more difficult to conduct policy dialogue. I mean, EBRD in the last years has really tried to ramp up its policy dialogue based on its operational expertise, and that has been going very, very well. Now, I think in the situation where you can't have face-to-face contact, you can't build the empathetic relationships that you would have otherwise done quite so easily because you're operating in an online way, in a virtual way, I think that has also made policy dialogue more of a test. And that policy dialogue is very important in terms of creating markets and creating, you know, the investment climate for institutions like EBRD, IFC, but also other strategic investors. So there have been some challenges there, but the overall immediate objective, I think, has been realized. Next phase, of course, in the recovery phase, is to try and tackle those challenges that I've just outlined.